Hey, it's Deborah Atkinson, founder of Flipping 50. I've got a core workout for you. So these are going to be short, 10 minutes, that's it. Honestly, 2.5 minutes or 5 minutes is my go-to daily. So listen, if you're doing high-intensity interval training, that is actually some of your best core exercise. If you're doing total body weight training workouts and you're using heavy weights, getting to fatigue, those exercises are also some of your best core exercises. They cause you to brace, and that is actually what causes you to have a flat stomach. Core exercise is not actually a great investment of time if you go beyond 2.5 to 5 minutes a day, maybe doing a little much. But we're gonna be doing a little bit of teaching here, so I want you to do these with me as you can. Not every exercise is made for everybody. So if you can't do one because you've got a shoulder issue and it depends on shoulder strength, throw it out because there's another one around the corner. All right, everything I do today is gonna be with a ball. So if you don't have a ball, again, skip this one, go to a different one. So we're gonna start with planks. So you're familiar with planks, either on extended arms or on your forearms. We're gonna put those forearms on the ball. So a couple ways you can do it. Here's a modification. So line goes from my knees to the crown of my head. That needs to be straight, whether I'm on my toes or I'm on my knees. So what you wanna make sure of is you're not up here. So is there a little bit of weight in my core working a little bit? Some, right? Not a lot. When I come up here, definitely, I can feel it. So coming up, I'm right here in a straight line. One should be sure also that if you're straight and you're using your feet, you're pushing back through your heels. You don't want to be out here. You want to be pressing back. That keeps everything from the crown of your head to the feet or the heels taut, which is what you want. Now, when I start to fatigue, you're going to see my hips creep up. We don't want them up, and we ideally don't want them down. So I want you engaged through the core for as long as you can, or as long as I'm holding it with you, or until you can't within that time span. Now, coming down, that was something between 30 seconds and a minute, so I'm not watching the clock, I'm watching you, and that's about as much as you want. The return on investment goes down the longer you hold it. Here's the biggest benefit. Right now, watch. My core just had to turn on. So letting it go on, short periods of time, these short repeats, coming down, let it go off, and then coming back on again. Some of the best value that you're gonna get, because what we need is when somebody's about to fall, when you're gonna catch yourself from falling, you have to react quickly. You need that core to go on. If we only do one long hold, how many times do we get to turn that on? Just once. So we're not really training for the way we need those muscles to work. Couple of details here. My elbows are right underneath my shoulders, not in here. Check. So if you don't have a mirror, I recommend you get one. Try to do one in front of a mirror just to check, okay? So make sure you're not letting it go too far. Later, we're gonna get to that. All right, take a little bit of a break. I'm gonna flip it over so we can give you a break. We're gonna come back here. If you're on carpet, know that your feet, unless you've got shoes on or the ball, may be more likely to slip. So I want you to be safe no matter where you are. So as you come here, I want your head resting back on the ball. So we're gonna do these. We're gonna hold on. We're gonna keep it out to the side, and we're not gonna roll up because that is essentially a crunch or a sit up. We don't need that kind of forward flexion. But what I do want you to do is to think about, can you move your arms? Can you change your center of gravity and make your core leverage just a little bit more? So if I move my arms and I move them out to the side, and if I had a weight in one arm but not in the other arm, my glutes, and they are part of your core, by the way, everything between knees and shoulders is, and my core is kind of steering the boat because things are moving around. So you can take your arms, you can circle them around, and you can feel that your core has to pay a little bit more attention here because you've got this long lever away from your core, and that is gonna make a wake-up call. So you can play with this. There's no right or wrong. You don't have to take it right or left. You don't have to take it up.
and then to the side or up and then down. But you'll notice when your arms are here, you have less work of all, the least amount of work. So try to move them. You can move them together or you can move them separately and just move one, pull the other one inside and see what the difference is. But the goal is to keep your hips and your shoulders stable while the levers are moving. Now, you can try to lift your legs. Gets a little tricky, and if you're falling over so much that you don't actually have time even to engage that core, just skip that one. So it's probably not nearly as effective as moving the arms. Okay, now, coming up, I've given you a little bit of a break, a little bit of a break for your shoulders. We're gonna come back to a couple of versions of making that more difficult. So when you're here and you can go to your toes and you're thinking, how do I make that more difficult? Here's one way. You're gonna circle around clockwise 3 times and then you're gonna go the opposite way. But again, you have to watch out. Your tendency is gonna wanna be to lift those hips. So you're gonna circle around 3 times here and reverse. So it goes 3 and 3 or go 5 and 5 if you feel like that was easy. Shake that out, because I've got another one for you. Now notice something. Now you're not probably talking back to a static camera. However, I'm talking and trying to do this. Can you feel or hear my breath gets a little bit more choppy, right? So that's okay, but what I want you to be cautious of, because you're holding still, make sure you're breathing. So count for yourself, 1, 2, so you've got that air coming in and out. That's actually gonna help you and keep you relaxed where you don't want tension. Next option, making it a little bit more challenging, but also keeping you engaged, all right? You come up, you've got good form. We're gonna take it away and back. Now, I'm not going long ways away, but again, it gets much more difficult, and I can definitely feel this in the lower abs. So I'm reaching away and bringing it back. And notice my heels, my knees, my hips, they're not going with it. It's just movement from the shoulder. So you do need to know who you are. If you got any shoulder issues, weight bearing on the shoulder, 1, throw that out. You certainly wouldn't do this one where we're depending on the shoulders even more. All right, so if you're still doing okay, another option, you're gonna spell, okay? So we've got circles, we've got out and in. Now, imagine spelling your name, just in cursive. What does that look like? So I've got Deborah, right, to deal with. So I'm just going to, in my mind's eye, imagine spelling it, and it's probably not gonna be very pretty. And then backward, right? So it's just getting it done, but it's keeping your mental engagement there. So you can't tune out when you're just doing those long holds. You can, and that's actually not really helpful. All right, another one with the ball. We're gonna come down on your side. Definitely gonna give you a little shoulder break. We're not going to put any weight on the shoulders. We're just gonna come down. We're gonna put the weight on the head, hand here. And I want you to make sure that you need this hand. So it's important that you couldn't be here and feel comfortable, because what's happening is that hip is probably a little back, and now you're working the front of the thigh instead of getting the alignment here. So we're actually working the side waist, your obliques that cross right here. So you need to have a little need for that hand. So rotate forward enough, you've got weight there. We're gonna lift and lower. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 to 10, 7, 8, 9, and 10, and we're gonna flip that to the other side. Now, you're gonna notice, most likely, you've got a good side and you've got an other side. And what I mean by that is, one where it'll be harder to lift, you won't lift as high, or it's just gonna feel like this is a struggle, right? So it may be the neural connection, like your brain connecting to the muscles on this side is not as strong because of your dominant, non-dominant status, or simply because now you're gonna be aware you actually have an imbalance. One side is your natural side. It's naturally stronger than the other. Little nuances like that and learning them can help you avoid injuries in other areas, to your knee, your hip, your feet, even a bunion can be caused by weak links in your abdominals. Who knew, right? All right, and relax. That was about 10. I'm gonna let that one go. I'm gonna have you come in, bring this to your back. I'm gonna go in this direction. What I'd like you to remember is you want their lower back, in this case, to be solid on the floor. So if you could imagine you have a belt on really at your waistband, your natural waist, I want you to tuck that down, put it on the floor, make sure your shoulders are relaxed, you're still breathing. So lower back being pressed down has nothing to do with your lungs, okay? Breathe in, breathe out. Don't have to hold your breath. Now you're gonna raise your legs up. So this is really dead buck, right? So your arms are up, lower back is down. Now put the ball in between. And in some cases, if you've got a really big ball, as I do, this is a 65 centimeter, it's a little too big to be comfortable. A 55 would be easier to handle, but I want you to push the knees into the ball. I want you to push your hand, so I'm squeezing it. Now, because I'm squeezing it, I'm gonna have to think more consciously about pushing my back down, not letting them pop up, pushing it down. And now I've got this effective feel of a plank while I'm doing it. Exhale. So again, I'm talking, that means I'm counting. Need you to be breathing here. Exhale. Nice job. And
relax. So there you have it. Some new, or maybe just a refresher on some ball core exercises that you knew that you're ready to grow into, or that you maybe can do some now, but have some ways to progress when you are ready. Hope that was helpful. Let me know if you have any problems, you have challenges, or you have questions about these below. And let me know if you've got a specific need and some challenges that you're looking for, any exercise that you're struggling with. We'll try to create a video just for you.